वेरी लवली गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल माई स्टूडेंट्स आउट देयर. नाउ आई एम बैक अगेन. आई एम डॉक्टर पूजा. एज यू ऑल नो, आई हैव बीन रिकॉर्डिंग सो मेनी बायोकेमिस्ट्री यू नो सेशंस विद यू गाइस फॉर द पास्ट 3-4 months. नाउ टुडे आई एम मेकिंग अ स्पेशल वीडियो फॉर द एस्पिरेंट्स हु आर एक्चुअली प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द एमसीआई एग्जाम, बिकॉज इट्स लाइक डे आफ्टर योर एग्जाम इज देयर. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट. डोंट गेट पैनिक. Read the question twice before attempting the answer. And I have kept a very small video. I will be just discussing the very important topic, the rate limiting enzymes. And tomorrow, let me see if I can summarize the entire biochemistry. I will be summarizing it tomorrow. So I am just discussing the rate limiting enzymes. Because you know this is such a topic in biochemistry on which the questions are bound to be asked. So first of all, you should know ki what are the different you know aspects. First of all, I'll just give you a brief thing. Let's take up carbohydrates. The basic structure and metabolism must be clear to all of you, and I don't want to go into depth of that because little time is left for your exam. So what I am going to do is, since I have kept the topic as rate limiting enzymes, so we'll just see different pathways, different cycles in carbohydrate metabolism and their rate limiting enzymes. So first of all, we are going to take up glycolysis. And another very important thing on which question can be asked is the site. कहां पे होता है, ठीक है. तो अब अगर हम ग्लाइकोलिसिस की बात करें, कहां पे होता है, इट अकर्स इन द साइटोसोल. एंड द रेट लिमिटिंग एंजाइम ऑफ ग्लाइकोलिसिस इज PFK1, फॉस्फोफ्रक्टोकाइनेस 1, राइट. देन वी मूव ओवर टू अनदर साइकिल, TCA, ट्राइकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. Or it is also known as Krebs cycle, as it was discovered by Sir Hans Krebs, and it is also known as citric acid cycle because the first stable product is citric acid cycle here. Okay, site it occurs in the matrix. Matrix kiski of mitochondria, and the rate limiting enzyme for TCA is ICD. Which stands for isocitrate dehydrogenase. Is it clear? Then we move over to the third pathway, which is very important. Which is the color? It is gluconeogenesis. Now, gluconeogenesis is that pathway which occurs in two organelles, cytoplasm and mitochondria, right? And the rate limiting enzyme for gluconeogenesis is fructose 2,6 bisphosphatase. Is it clear? Then, fourth pathway in carbohydrate metabolism is HMP. First of all, you should know that this HMP stands for, it is not a cycle, it is a shunt. Why it is a shunt? Because it does not have any end product. Site kahan pe hota hai? It occurs in the cytoplasm again. The rate limiting enzyme of HMP shunt is glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. Right, then this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and fifth one is again very important, glycogenesis, synthesis of glycogen in the cytosol, and the rate limiting enzyme of glycogenesis is glycogen synthase. Because always remember, the questions which are asked in biochemistry are basically mainly on these rate limiting enzymes. Then another important process is glycogenolysis. ग्लाइकोजेनोलाइसिस अकर्स इन द साइटोसोल एंड सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग अबाउट दिस ग्लाइकोजेनोलाइसिस इज टू सम एक्सटेंट इट अकर्स इन द लाइसोसोम्स आल्सो एंड द रेट लिमिटिंग एंजाइम इज ग्लाइकोजन फॉस्फोराइलेस. इज इट क्लियर? सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट pathways or shunts of carbohydrate metabolism and their rate limiting enzymes. I'm just giving you the superficial thing because this is the time when you just have to brush up your knowledge before appearing for the exam. And one question is bound to come from this rate limiting enzymes only. Then next topic is say proteins. Proteins में the most important thing you should know is, वैसे तो proteins is itself a vast topic. You have seen the you know different type of amino acids, their fate as per their glucogenicity, their fate as per their ketogenicity. But here since my topic is just rate limiting enzymes, so here I'll just stick to one. That is urea cycle. Urea cycle is another cycle which occurs in two organelles, cytoplasm and mitochondria. Right? And the rate limiting enzyme is CPS1. CPS1 is present in the mitochondria, which is wholly solely an enzyme of urea cycle. Then another very important thing about this I'm going to tell you here is about little bit about oxidative deamination. Now, what is this oxidative deamination of glutamic acid? And the name of the enzyme here is glutamate dehydrogenase, which is a zinc-containing enzyme. Okay. Since again I'm telling you my topic here is simple, the rate-limiting enzymes, so I'm not going into that much detail. Then we come over to after proteins comes fats. In fats, lipogenesis is there and lipolysis is there. Right? If we talk about lipogenesis, it occurs in the cytoplasm. And the rate limiting enzyme here is acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase. And this acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase requires biotin for its action. Since it is carboxylation, so wherever carboxylation occurs, biotin is required. And lipolysis, if we talk about lipolysis, mein simple lipase enzyme is there. Whether it is hormone sensitive lipase or whether it is simple lipoprotein lipase, right? But here if we talk about the question which can be asked in the exam is regarding the fats, and the rate limiting enzyme of fats is acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase. So this is a very small class, I should say, a very class of very short duration, right? Tomorrow I am going to discuss the entire biochemistry in detail along with the basics. So before going, before appearing for your exam, just go through the details. And if you guys have any problem, you can log into my website. My website is biochemistry simplified. .com. So I think this is more than enough for today. Tomorrow I will be discussing the entire portion of biochemistry in detail so that when you go for your exam, just go through it again. Thanks a lot. Good night. Take care.